10.3 Muslim Culture by Adam Campbell and Brian Field. There were many Muslim cities, such as Damascus, Baghdad, Cordoba, Cairo, and Jerusalem. Damascus was the leading city until Baghdad came along. Baghdad became the leading city and was also the cultural center of Islam. Cordoba was the Umayyad capital and Cairo was the Fatimid capital. It was typical for large cities to have multiple social classes, such as the upper class, which was Muslim people at birth. Second class was converts to Islam. Third class was the Christians, Jews, and Zoroastrians. And the lowest class were slaves from prisoners of war. Men were the managers of the women's affairs, but they were treated equal in the Islam faith. Men could divorce their wives by saying, "I dismiss thee," 3 times, but women were responsible for raising the children. Muslim literature was mostly Bedouin poems about the desert life. They contained traits such as bravery, love, generosity, and hospitality. Artists in the Muslim culture were not allowed to draw images of life like plants or animals because they believed Allah created all things. Instead, they used calligraphy or beautiful handwriting to use as a religious drawing. The Great Mosque of Damascus was built over the site of a Christian church. The architecture of this building was similar to a Byzantine architecture, but with an Islamic flair. It contained a huge dome and a vaulted ceiling. Medical advancements were mostly by a man named Al-Razi, who is known as the greatest physician in the world at that day and age. He wrote many books called comprehensive books about his research. For example, Treatises on Smallpox and Measles was a comprehensive book of remedies for smallpox and measles. He also said one of the best cures for disease is clean air. Muslims believe that math and science was the basis for all knowledge. They used astrology and mathematics to locate which direction Mecca was during their prayer. The ideal man was known as Eastern Persian derivation, Arabic in faith, and has an Iraqi education, a Hebrew and Athusianist, a disciple of Christian in conduct, as pious as a Greek monk, a Greek in individual sciences, an Indian in the interpretation of all mysteries, but also Sufi in his whole spiritual life. In conclusion, the Muslim faith is very strict, and as Christians, we believe that this is a false religion. But I'm not one to control you, and you have your own opinion. But there are many positive reasons people are Islamic, but we don't know it all.